بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى by his wisdom decided to favor people upon others and decided to favor times upon others and decided to favor places upon others. Now among the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to give a special favor for prophets and messengers. Upon prophets and messengers themselves, we have أولي العزم من الرسول. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala فضلهم. They gave him a special status. نوح, إبراهيم, موسى, عيسى, محمد, صلى الله عليه وسلم. They have a special status upon other prophets and messengers. We come to places. Now, the earth belongs to Allah. Allah is the created. However, the masajid have a special status. Among the masajid, we have Mecca, Medina, and al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Now, let's come to times. Times are part of the khalq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. However, Allah decided to give a special status for the last third of each night. A special status for the Fajr prayer. وقرآن الفجر إن قرآن الفجر كان مشهودا. We have Ramadan as a time, the last 10 days of Ramadan, which we have started just a few hours ago, and the 10 days of Dhu al-Hijjah, as you know. والفجر وليالٍ عشر. The 10 days of ليالٍ عشر in chapter or Surah al-Fajr, it's where the 9th will be يوم عرفة. Now we are in one of the most important times that gave a special status by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now I will not be quoting the hadith of Laylatul Qadr because you all know it. But what you should not focus just on to put in yourself, it's just 27 and that's it. I think you might be committing a big mistake. Now if you want really to be on the safe side, take advantage of the last 10 days. Forget the concept of now Fardi and Zawji. If you don't have a time, focus on the odd, you know, for example, not the even. But if you have a time, let me just give you a quick like program, just what to do, to be fair with ourselves. Those who have full control on their time, it's highly preferable to do the i'tikaf. Alhamdulillah, we have brothers now here, about 35 of them, they are doing the i'tikaf, which means 24/7, they are stuck in the masjid doing the proper i'tikaf all the time in prayer, dua and time. May Allah accept from them and inshallah they will not forget us in their dua. طيب, the majority of us, we can't do i'tikaf for many reasons. Okay? Those who are, you have children, they have to go to school. Not every one of us can take, you know, for example, off from his work. His work in a non-Muslim company, they don't understand this. They don't allow, it's not easy, whatever. You have your own reasons. You have someone who needs a special care at home. You must drive to give a lift for your daughter, your wife, your whatever, whatever. Now, let's think now. The thing that I advise you, respected brother and sister, just do upgrading for what you do. Do something better. Just do something better. If you are from those who pray the Taraweeh and they go just to sleep, before you sleep, pray extra. If you pray the Taraweeh, which is part of your normal daily program, you go and chat with your family and your wife, for example, instead of chatting and sitting and speaking, just read one juz of the Quran. Just do something better of what you used to do. If your normal program that you just wake up to have the suhoor, then the fajr, half an hour before the suhoor, exclusively, just 2 rak'ah, reading half a juz and make a dua. Whatever extra is better if you can. The core points, your sincerity and your attitude. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bi-idhnillah will grant the qabool. The idea, you know, one of the most important things, which is the most famous hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal idha ja'at al-ashru al-awakhir shadda mi'zarahu wa ayqadha ahlahu. Now it's a metaphorical, you know, shadda mi'zarahu, you know, the mi'zar, this is, you know, the cloth, this type of cloth, they use this mi'zar. قال شد مئزره. It's a metaphor of he took it very seriously. He started doing much more extra effort in ibadah. Okay? Which means do your best to do extra. Each one of us, some of you can do i'tikaf, but you can come daily on the special qiyam after the tarawih. By the way, the tarawih is qiyam. Tarawih in itself is qiyam. But we have an extra qiyam, which is 1:30 to 3. If you are next to the masjid, please do it. If you can't come, do something at home. if whatever, just take a decision to do something extra. Don't leave these 10 days, but you have changed your program in the following: reciting the Quran, focusing in understanding the Quran, making a focused, deep, sincere dua, and extra prayer apart from the jama'ah, just by your own, in your own musalla at home, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in whatever you wish. And I will remind you about something I did. You know, whatever you pray, whatever you make a dua, bi-idhnillah, you will find a response. But remember that Allah has four different ways of responding to your dua. Don't make the dua and think that whatever you want directly, because we explained that before that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your deeds and keep dua, all of us, to each other. Whenever you start the prayer, please, part of your dua, ud'u li ikhwanika hawlak. You see, we say, Ya Allah, for example, prepare, because when you have a sincere dua for the rest, it will be much more pure and sincere, because you have no direct interest in it. For example, when you dua yourself, Ya Allah, respond to my brother to my left, respond to my brother to my left. Ya Allah, everyone in this masjid, make it easy for him. Ya Allah, solve the problems. If everyone is asking, why are you asking yourself? This will bring you more ajr. And all of us, we never know which one of us is mustajab al-da'wah. We have no idea. We don't know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. So when every one of us makes the dua for everyone else, inshallah, at a certain point, maybe all of us will leave every night, maghfurun lakum, inshallah, to be from those who are freed from the slavery of the hellfire. Itq. من النار اللهم آمين تقبل الله طاعتكم جزاكم الله خير السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.